Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Oasis, but an Oasis special. And we've called it a singing Sunday, because guess what? We're going to sing. Yes? So we've got lots of good worship songs and hymns to come, and they'll all be projected on the screen. So please do look at the screen for the words, in case you don't know them. We do have some activities for children, and I see that the bags have been given out. Because today we're celebrating through music. And our Bible reading tells us what worship is like in heaven. So we're going to invite to join in making and using instruments as we sing our way through our worship this morning. So you should have a shaker, a bat, no, sorry, bells, streamer, and we just ask that you leave your pens and remaining materials in the box at the back of church when you leave. But feel free to take your instruments home to annoy your parents and keep them awake all night. Yeah. It was Emma. Emma's words, not mine. So we've just had some more folk join us, so we'll just wait for them to come in. Yes, it's good to be back, and good to be together, and good to worship God, because he is the one who deserves our glory. And I have a few reflections, and I don't know if anybody else knows about this, a few reflections to make on the theme of worship based on our Bible reading. So I'll pop them in at various points as we go through our worship. So all right, welcome, good to have you. So we're going to begin by singing our first hymn, which is Come, Now Is the Time to Worship.
Stand.
Come, now is the time to worship.
confused before, and that's because I was. Because actually, on my PowerPoint that I've got in front of me, that was not the first song. So, dear Lord and Father of mankind. That's on the PowerPoint. No?
No.
It's on the one I've got here.
Let's
do that, and then we'll get back to the order that I have put to me. And we've got some responses in a moment, just to praise God and give him the glory he deserves. Dear Lord and Father of mankind, forgive our foolish ways.
Never before.
this is the day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. Let's rejoice.
Revelations chapter 5, the scroll and the lamb. And I saw on the right hand of him who sat on the throne a scroll with writing on both sides, and sealed with seven seals. And I saw a mighty angel proclaiming in a loud voice, "Who is worthy to break the seals and open the scroll?" Then I saw a lamb, looking as if it had been slain, standing at the center of the throne, encircled by the four living creatures and the elders. The Lamb had seven horns and seven eyes, which are the seven spirits of God, sent out into all the earth. He went and took the scroll from the right hand of him who sat on the throne. And when he had taken it, four living creatures and the 24 elders fell down before the Lamb. Each one had a harp, and they were holding golden bowls full of incense, which are the prayers of God's people. And they sang a new psalm, saying, "You are not worthy to take the scroll and to open its seals, because you were slain, and with your blood you purchased for God persons from every tribe and language and people and nation. You have made them to be a kingdom and priests to serve our God, and they will reign on the earth." Then I looked, and I heard the voice of many angels, numbering thousands upon thousands, and 10,000 times 10,000. They encircled the throne and the living creatures and the elders. In a loud voice they were saying, "Worthy is the Lamb who was slain to receive power and wealth and wisdom and strength and honour and glory and praise." And I heard every creature in heaven and on earth and under the earth and on the sea and all that is in them saying, "To him who sits on the throne and to the Lamb be praise and honour and glory and power for ever and ever." Four living creatures said, "Amen," and the elders fell down and worshipped. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you. invite Lucy and Dean to come. And well, Dean's going to be interviewed by Lucy. So good luck with that, Dean.
I'm prepared, so I'm okay. So there's nothing to hopefully shock me. Right. I don't know what I'm going to do with this. Is this where I'm supposed to sit?
Yeah.
Right.
This is where you want to sit.
Right.
So this is a little bit of a throw-off from the Men of Faith interviews that I did whilst we were in lockdown and we couldn't meet in church. And Emma and Simon have asked me if I'd do a little interview with Dean for the service today, because we can sing again for the music service. So we picked Dean. So usually, I used to have a little chat with my people who I was going to interview, because I'd interview them online over Zoom and then record it and then we'd play it in the service. So I'd have a little chat and warm them up a little bit. So to get Dean warmed up, because I can't just have a little chat with him because you're all here, I thought we'd do some quick fire questions first.
Right.
And then Dean's going to answer some of these musically, and mainly the children, but also the adults have got to guess what the answers are. Okay. So it's a little test for you all. So I'm warming you all up, really. So we'll start with what your favourite hymn was as a child.
Right. So I'm going to answer this not quite as I should do. I'm going to answer by saying that this is one of my favourite hymns, and I use it an awful lot because I've done lots and lots of assemblies when I used to work. I know you're busy, but I don't know your name.
Ellen.
Ellen, I'm going to play a bit of a tune, and you've got to tell me what you think the hymn is. Is that all right? Can you try this? Just that I'm going to play about two bars of it. You've got to guess what it is. Here it comes. And it's a favourite. That's all you get. I really like that one because a couple of lines in it. And it is this, give me courage when the world is rough. Keep me loving though the world is tough. Leap and sing in all I do, keep me travelling along with you. And it's a lovely kind of set of words to go with a jolly tune as well. Perhaps you all know One More Step Along the World. Shall we sing a verse of it? One More Step Along the World, I go. Well, it's not on the screen though. Can you manage a bit of that? One more step along the world I go, from the old I travel to the new.
So that's what makes my quick fire round. So next question is,
I've got another favourite. Right, okay, so this might be adults, but Ellen might know this one. This is a favourite, and if I just play a little bit of it, perhaps the adults will have to help with this one. Anybody recognise? I wasn't playing very well. Rachel.
Rachel's
gone.
When a knight won his spurs.
When a knight won his spurs.
Yeah.
It's the one I can remember singing at school 60 years ago at my primary school in Kirkburton in Huddersfield. And the idea of this knight winning his spurs, going out to battle against the forces of evil. It's sort of the same tune, actually, is used in a Christmas carol, which is, Chrissy, what is it? How far is it to Bethlehem? Not very far. Shall we see a statement? Sorry, that's that.
Welcome back. So, Dean, what was the first instrument that you learned to play?
Well, lots of you know, we kind of, Chrissy and I come from a kind of Salvation Army background, and so the first instrument I learned as a young kid about 5 or 6 years old was a cornet, which is a bit like a trumpet, and my dad kind of taught me to play, and my brothers as well, so we played in the Salvation Army band, and it started from that, and I moved on to the trumpet when I got about 12 or 13, more with trumpet, yeah.
And I know that you play many instruments, but what is your favourite instrument?
It's a difficult one, Matt. I mean, if I'm saying which is my main instrument, it has to be the trumpet, because that's what I did when I went to kind of university. I went to, it's too long ago that I went to university, really. But in the 71, 74, I went to Sheffield University, and trumpet was the first instrument, piano was the second, and then I spent a bit of time playing guitar as well, but it'd be nice to play one instrument really, really well. Sadly, I don't, but there we go.
I'm scared to ask this, but what is your favourite song from church?
We've already had it, so we don't have to sing it again. And that is actually, Dear Lord and Father of Mankind, I don't know who chose that, but perhaps, you know, the Lord is working in a strange way here in this service, because that is, over the years, has meant a huge amount to me. The words and the marriage of Paul Williams' tune is absolutely priceless. And each verse, to me, music only kind of stands out well when the words and the tune kind of match each other. And for me, that second or third verse of "Drop thy still views of quietness, till all our striving cease. Take from our souls the strain and stress, then let our ordered lives confess the beauty of thy peace." It doesn't get any better than that. And the strength of music, of course, is that when we can hang the tune onto the words and we're going about our daily lives, if a tune like that can do that to you, then the words will come, the reassurance, the reminder that God is around us. So that is a real priceless one, and it's worth revisiting again and again and again.
That's nice. Now back to the piano. You've got to play us a tune from your favourite band.
Right.
And we've got to guess who you are. Okay.
Right, a little story here, and I'll be controversial. I'm actually, I don't see the limelight, believe it or not, but in about 1985, I was teaching in a school in Sheffield, in a tough school in Sheffield, and at that time they used to call Sheffield the Republic of South York, Socialist Republic of South Yorkshire. It was very left-wing, and the powers that be, the Labour Party, wanted to use some children singing a song. And I'm going to play the opening for the song and see if you recognise it. And they use this as a party political broadcast, believe it or not, but it's a lead-in to my favourite band. See if you can recognise the song just from the introduction, if I play it right. Imagine. It is John Lennon, Imagine. And for about 1.5 seconds, my hands were on national television playing that little introduction. And the idea was that the Labour Party wanted this notion of young children singing about Imagine the no war. It's controversial because the words of John Lennon say there will be no religion too. But I like the sentiment and the global aspect of it. sadly, it didn't do any favours for Neil Kinnock. He was an honourable gent, good man, I think, but he didn't become Prime Minister because of that particular broadcasting word. But there we go. Beatles, I'm afraid, is my favourite band, mainly because they were so unparalleled in what they were doing, and they moved with the times, their musical style moved with the times. Yeah.
So now we're into the meaty questions.
Right.
So would you like to tell us first about the role of music in your personal and professional life?
Right, okay, so we kind of touched on that a little bit. My parents, I think, would have preferred me to do a proper job, but I really enjoyed doing music, so I ended up going to Sheffield and doing a BMus degree, and then some letters, social law, college of music, that kind of stuff. So teaching was the thing that I kind of got into. And if when I get there, you know, they say, well, what did you do? I'll say I was a primary school teacher, a fairly average one, perhaps, but I've been fortunate. I think we both, Christina, I feel fortunate in the jobs that we've done. You know, they have had strain and stress associated with them, but we've loved working with children and doing stuff, and music has been a big part of that for me. So I've spent 20 years working in Church of England schools, and then the last 10 doing teacher training. George Bernard Shaw was a very insightful writer, and he said, those who can do, those who can't teach, and those who can't teach, teach teachers. So that could be right at the bottom of the pile there, but I, you know, I do feel very fortunate. That's why I've spent 39 years of my professional career doing it. Yeah. Did that answer the question?
Now we can sing in church again,
yeah.
And we've been able to use music throughout the lockdowns and the COVID bits and bobs through our services in and out of church. But what is your view of worship through music and song,
yeah,
and how does that tie in with your faith and,
yes,
your worship?
Okay, so I'll go back to the Salvation Army here, because William Booth, who founded the Salvation Army, who started it off, was a great Victorian radical reformer. He was a Methodist minister, and then he started off this Salvation Army bit. And so much of our lives have been kind of around that music making bit, whether it's bands or choirs or whatever. But William Booth said that the devil shouldn't have all the best tunes. And by that he meant that, you know, there are lots of songs that were kind of being sung in the pubs and all over the place. And for worship, all we need to do is marry decent words to good tunes. And I think that is so crucial. I mean, I have favourites because I've kind of done quite a lot of music, and you know, whether it's kind of Handel's Messiah, whether it's the Dream of Gerontius, you know, praise to the holiest in the height and in the depths be praised. The words of Henry Newman are so strong and powerful. And it's not one that you'd want to go home and listen to and sing along with, but if you're into strong music, the Dream of Gerontius doesn't get any stronger than that. So music can kind of do so much that other things can't, but only when it's, as I say, married to words. At the moment, we both like Howard Godall's music. Has anybody heard of Howard Godall? Yeah, one or two hands going up. If you've not heard of him, you've heard his music, because he wrote some music like this. So, Vicar of Dibley, he also wrote the QI theme tune. He's written the Blackadder theme tunes and the Upstart Crow, so lots of TV music. But if you're interested in kind of music and songs,
look up on YouTube Howard Gogol's Love Divine or Love's Excelling, because he's really lovely, really, really beautiful music. Love Divine or Love's Excelling, Joy of Heaven to Earth Come Down. So music can speak to us all in different ways, you know, and as I say, for me, I've sadly missed singing over lockdown, as I'm sure we all have, but you know, we need to make sure that we try and, in terms of worship, I think, just try and keep so many of the good hymns going, because Dear Lord and Father of Mankind, Love Divine or Love's Excelling, those words have a depth to them, they have kind of theology behind them. And I'm not saying worship songs don't, but they kind of perform a different function. And I think we need to kind of spin as many plates as possible musically. Yeah. Does that make kind of sense?
I like your little link back to when you're at home and you think of the tune and the words. That's nice. I like that. So the direction of church music and worship through song, where do you see it going in the future? Because church is changing all the time and the face of church is changing.
Yes.
Where do you see the music and the music time to the worship going?
I think actually it's kind of doing that now. I mean, I feel very sorry for folk like Geoff, who's got to kind of please everybody all the time. It must be impossible. But on the other hand, I think we have to move with the times. So we have to, you know, make what we do and what we believe as relevant to the younger generation. Otherwise, we're going to die, aren't we? Well, let's be honest. So we have to make things attractive. By the same time, we make sure what we present, what we use musically, has an intrinsic value to it. And I mean, you know, for instance, Graham Kendrick's songs have that, absolutely. All his songs, I think, have that sense of, you know, of a background, of a knowledge, of an experience of God and what he can do. So I think that's the challenge, to kind of, as a spin plate, to have as many, keep the strong old hymns going, but by the same token, use modern songs that are good and have intrinsic value.
Great. That was great, Dee. We almost kept to the 15 minutes. That was really good. Thank you so much.
Right. Sometimes, our songs are actually more of a declaration of what we believe. And that's what this next song is. This I Believe. It's a bit like a creed, but it declares what we actually believe as Christians, meeting together to worship God, but to live out our daily lives as well. This I Believe.
One picture that we go through this, and I believe in you, I believe in you, rose again, I believe that Jesus Christ and the Lord, if you follow Master, it will be alright. Following on from Dean's theme there, if you're not a musician, play guitar, and that's what I've done, so.
Father everlasting, we all create. God Almighty, through your Holy Spirit, conceiving Christ the Son, Jesus our Savior. I believe in God our Father, I believe in Christ the Son, I believe in the Holy Spirit, our God is free and one. I believe in the resurrection, that we will rise again, for I believe in the name of Jesus. Our judge and our defender suffered and crucified.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for the angels that praise you in heaven all day, every day. That give you the glory you deserve. May we join in with those angels, praising you in all things, in all aspects of our lives. We sing.
Oh Lord, hear my prayer. Oh Lord, hear my prayer. When I call, answer me. Oh Lord, hear my prayer. Oh Lord, hear my prayer.
Pray that you would bring peace into our world. We pray for those nations where there is no peace, And particularly at this time, we pray for Afghanistan, for those people who are feeling vulnerable and uneasy, those who are struggling to find any peace in their lives at the moment. May you speak into the lives of the Taliban, change their hearts. O Lord, hear my prayer. Made. We pray for our economy. May we work together as a nation to seek equality and fairness for all. O Lord, hear my prayer. Churches. We pray for guidance and wisdom. We pray that we would be able to reach out to our communities in love and in action, in prayer and in faith. O Lord, hear my prayer. And hospital appointments, those who are facing devastating diagnoses, those who are uncertain of what their future holds. Bring them healing, bring them peace. And we pray for comfort and strength for those who have lost loved ones, those who feel the pain and the wrench that that loss is to them. Be their comfort and strength. O Lord, hear my prayer. Right.
we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom, and the power of the Lord, ever and ever. Amen. And now we sing, God is for us.
Can you stand? Very lively.
His face shining on.
Which is taking place in Glasgow, and there's a group of young people who have been doing a relay from Penzance all the way to Glasgow, and they're passing through York, or through Copplethorpe, in fact, tomorrow at 12:30, and they'll be stopping here for teas, coffees, and their own packed lunches. So if you wanted to come along and just be here for that, that's about 12:30. Obviously, they're walking, so we can't give an accurate time, but that's roughly when they'll be here. So if you want to pop in for that, that is fantastic. What else is happening this week? Well, next Saturday is our Vision Day. It's not too late to sign up. We are providing food, so that was the reason for a deadline of Thursday, but I am sure that there'll be plenty of food if people just turn up on the day. But it is really helpful if we know how many, because we know how many chairs to put out. So please do come along if you want to join us for our Vision Day. It's a day about discerning what God is calling us to do and be as churches. So please do make every effort to join in as we gather for that next Saturday. Are there any other announcements? I hate to talk about money, but you can make a donation to the church as you leave. And actually, there is a card machine which we can take donations on if you don't actually have paper money put in the collection. So, go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Amen.
And thank you to our musicians for playing so well.
Rise up to